Link engaged.
Visit us at teamspeak.com.
Welcome back, everyone, to the TL Open number 16, sponsored by TeamSpeak yet again. We're over here in set number 2 on Shattered Temple, choosing the Pink Terran at the 9 o'clock is 6 Jacks Major, down 0-1 to free agent Inca in the red Protoss. As we mentioned, they're close by air, so this opens up a lot of dropper opportunities for 6 Jacks Major. I want to go ahead and remind TLO and everyone at home to tune in tomorrow for TL Attack, when we're going to be having Root Cats on, and we'll get to the bottom of everything that happened at MLG. Trust me, we'll get to the bottom of it.
Okay, I'm definitely going to be watching. That sounds extremely interesting. Pretty standard play by Inca from the beginning, doing a really early scout, and actually scouting to the left. I like that a lot. You know, I wonder how many people, like how many percentage of the people scout to the right instead to the left. Right. I'm pretty sure it's like 80 against 20.
Yeah, I think
and,
so.
It's pretty small to actually mix it up. Every player should just flip a coin at the beginning of the game and then randomly decide which direction he wants to scout in, because that makes you a lot more unpredictable and doesn't really hurt your game.
Yeah, for sure. And actually, some players have builds where they want to do a build in certain positions, and if he's in the other position, it doesn't matter. So, well, I'm not sure this is happening. It's possible that Inca has a build, or he wants to play one style if they're close by air, and then if they're close by ground or cross positions, he doesn't really care. So he gets in there, finds out.
I think I might be terribly wrong. He's probably not even able to spawn close position, because the recent Shadow Temple versions are all either cross spot or close by air. Sorry about that.
There we go. We got to the bottom of it.
But it would be smart anyways.
If it happened, it would be smart. We got a little probe versus SCV gladiator action. A probe gonna be brought down, 17 HP, gonna try to get in there. Major blocking out his own SCV as the battle rages on. Pretty standard build meanwhile back in home by Inca. He's got the cybernetic score completing. Go see
some
Terran
confusion
not
going on. Having three SCVs out there for a while and almost getting the probe in anyways. A little bit of plunder by Major there, lost a tad of a mining time, but at least he completely denied scouting, even though the probe actually came up on first position.
Yeah, I wonder how much information Inca got from that, because, you know, sitting from the lofty throne of the observer position, we can see Major going for a gasless expansion. I wonder if Inca, you know, thinks, wow, he really tried a lot to deny that scouting, and he got his wall up very quickly. That second supply depot was very quick to deny any scouting, so I wonder if he can put the pieces together and figure out that it's a fast expansion coming from Major.
Yeah, I mean, you always get a little bit worried if you don't scout anything at all. It might always be a little bit of cheese coming up. But if you throw down that second depot so fast, I don't think you can even afford a gas, to be honest.
I don't know, mules are pretty good.
Well, you don't have mules, man.
Got the probe being chased away by Major running into the 12 o'clock. Let's see if Inca can pull some magic, keep this guy alive as he swings around. And looks like it's not gonna happen.
No, not I. Finally, that all that effort by the Marine pays out, walking across the map. He must be so exhausted now.
Got the robotics up for Inca, so this is a prime position for warp prism play yet again. Let's see if he does that. He's pushing out with his first Zealot and Stalker. Gonna be able to move in. He's gonna see this bunker and be able to put the pieces together. He's gonna get a free Marine kill, possibly. Major pulling that back, and yes, he does keep it alive, so very nice by him.
Yeah, very nice job, and a little bit of bad micro by Inca there, but does he finally get? Oh, he gets it after all.
Yeah, he actually sniped it. Continuing to push forward, he actually got drawn into the bunker there a little bit. Robotics is about to complete. He's got his two assimilators complete. Looks like Inca is going to expand and not go for the warp prism play I was praying for, but it probably would not have worked out anyway. He's got three barracks up this time. Not going for any sort of quick tech like Ravens and sacrificing the backbone army. He's just going for a strong, muscly Terran here off those three barracks.
Yeah, absolutely. The only thing which might have worked is doing a really cheesy build, which relies on force feeding the ramp and then warping in more and more units, but that is very gimmicky and hard to pull off, and relies on a lot of mistakes of your opponent as well.
Yeah, we saw a 6 Jack Major dropping that scan so he can see exactly what's going up. got his observer flying into the main base of Major Inca does, so he's going to be able to see exactly what sort of production is in there. Not being very active with that, Major pushes out to the middle of the map, gains control of that Zelnaga watchtower, and then comes back. Here goes the observer. I like to see a Protoss player who's very active with that observer, keeps it actually on a hotkey and flies it around. We can see that it's on number 2 here for Inca, so he's going to be active with that.
And we do have a shuttle coming out after all now, so that is very interesting.
But only 2 warp gates.
Yeah, but still.
But still.
Yeah, still.
But you know, he can elevator. There's a nice little patch of darkness here.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And Zigzag Major doesn't have like a ton of units. He's going for early Ghost, and Stimpak is not finished yet. And dealing with Stalkers plus Sentries without Stimpak is not really nice.
Here goes the Warp Prism. He's going to load up and start dropping into the darkness, putting on Zigzag Major's vision. Completely unaware of this, he's got.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! What is that? Magic SCV.
Yeah, absolutely. He did have some spider senses there. Going probably wanted to put up a depot to actually, yeah, defeat stuff like that. And a little bit of luck by Major or just perfect timing. Who knows?
His Artosis senses were tingling.
Yeah.
We've got the Twilight Council completed. Let's see if he goes DT. He's stockpiling a little bit of gas here. Nothing coming out of the Twilight Council yet. He's up to 2.
Yes, there it goes. Wow. Twilight Council. No engineering bay yet. But Ghost Academy. So I'd say Major is in a pretty good spot to be prepared. As long as he saves up one scan, he's gonna be fine.
Right. But you know, he may not be thinking about Dark Templar because Inca showed that Warp Prism very quickly. It may be in his mind that he deflected that.
If you actually, you know, I have been talking a lot of Food War in the casting today, but if you actually still in the mindset of Food War, and Major obviously is a very experienced Food War player, you're always gonna think of DTs if you see a shuttle as well, right?
That's true, but it's not that commonplace in StarCraft 2 yet. Yeah. In StarCraft 1, you know, DT drops were the bread and butter of people who wanted free wins, PvT.
Hey, don't insult me,
man. Did you do that? Are you a DT dropper?
Yeah, of course, every single game.
You and Faith. Do you know Faith, the Canadian?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He was my idol.
Oh, yeah? I was at a LAN with him once, and I'm like, man, you need to win this to advance. What are you going to do? And he ran through like 15 builds that he might do. And he's like, oh, I'll probably just DT drop.
Yeah, well, DT Rebar drop was my favorite build, actually. One base, proxy gate, proxy robotics.
Kilo dropping all his knowledge. Look at this, Major may catch a few units here in the middle of the map. Doesn't want a Stim to take him out. Just wants to move forward. He's gonna get a Zealot, but does not get the all-important Sentry. That Sentry is 200 energy.
Absolutely, and there's a strong force coming out. A lot of scans saved up, so he's gonna be prepared for DTs. No need for an EMP even. He can just save it against Data DTs. In the meantime, there's a DT in the main base of Major taking out a lot of SCVs, but a scan is coming down.
Oh,
units
that was
not
a bad scan.
Oh yeah, units not attacking the DT at all. Up to 12 kills now, and it still lives.
He's got one scan left at his natural. He's going to use that now, and he's at 40 energy on his main, 47 at his natural. So 2 DTs will be able to be taken out by scans. He's bringing one more DT to try to take out the natural. Majors just has so many scans, and he's going to be able to build them up so quickly. I don't think there's anything Inca can really do here.
No, and having lost his base, there's basically no coming back for him. He does have a robotics bay, but Major even does have a reactor starport already. Stockpiled a lot of money for Inca as well, so being thrown out of his game, being really far behind. And as I said, if you go for a ghost build, that is almost a perfect counter against DTs, to be honest.
Mm-hmm. And he's now got missile turrets up even, so he can begin dropping those mules yet again. Major's macro has been very nice here. He's getting a lot of production. Just out of 3 barracks, he's got his medevacs out now to help him heal up, and yeah, I'm trying to imagine a universe where Inca can come back from this, but not putting the pieces together.
I don't know, it looks very grim for him, even losing a medevac. Oh, no, okay, it gets away, but it doesn't really matter. It's not like he's gonna be doing anything with it anyways. Oh, now Marine's stepping and taking out.
Oh, wow.
And scan goes down, DTs goes down, and there's only a very, very frail army for Protoss left.
Yeah, I mean, it just really comes down to when does Major want to win? Does he want to win now or in 5 minutes? Let's see, he's pushing forward. He's got his Ghost in the front. Gonna drop an EMP on the majority of the Protoss units. Gonna do a little bit of dancing there. Force field's going up, but everything melts to Six Jacks Major as he stims and moves forward. And this is gonna be it, GG. Only a single Colossus left. Stim wears off, but you know, Colossus aren't that good. And that's gonna be it.
No, Colossus are not that advanced. And here comes the GG.
It's no Reaver DT.
No, absolutely not. There are no Spider-Mans either, which can just blow up the entire Terran army.
True. Need to get some SC2 Brood War going on.
Yeah, it's actually your fault of you guys, because I played StarCraft 2 Brood War on TL Attack.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like thinking about Brood War every day again now.
So it's my fault that you're thinking about Brood War? Is that
yeah,
what you're saying?
You made me miss it.
Okay. Is it my fault that your wrist is injured too?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's because I was playing Brood War and you actually need a lot of APM for it, so I hurt my wrist.
Brood War's pretty hard, man.
I know. It hurts.
I go back to playing Brood War, I'm like, oh man, I need to rally my workers? What is this?
Yeah. You get so exhausted after 15 minutes, you're like, oh man, that's actually not playing a game, that's actually work.
But you know, I'm sure that SC2 is going to get there. Give it like another year, and I'm sure we're going to see people microing individual units like Brood War.
I know. I'm not saying StarCraft 2 is not as good. I think it might even have almost more potential than StarCraft 1 in what you can do. It's just harder, because the game is faster. So it's actually, in one way, people say StarCraft 1 is much harder than StarCraft 2. But I think it's at the same time StarCraft 2 is harder than StarCraft 1. Just gonna throw that out there, and you should think about it.
That's very deep. TLO dropping some philosophical knowledge on us here in this TL Open.
Important to stay smart and keep.
True. You gotta stay sharp. Stay in school, kids.
Yeah, don't trip out. Okay. Don't be like Mauro.
All right, so. Let's bring it back to the current state of the game. We're at 1-1 in this Terran versus Protoss. The winner of this final rubber match is going to move on to the best of five, which is going to be the finals against Huangshin, the Korean Protoss waiting in the finals. The winner of that is going to take home $100. Second place is going to take home $50 for their effort. Third and fourth going to take home $25. TLO, are you ready for game number three?
I know. You know the answer.
I know. So that's it. We're going to be moving to game number three right after this.